Everyone, welcome to Ningning Mandarin. 大家好，我是宁宁。Welcome back to my series, Learn Chinese in Stories. 听故事，学中文。This is the second episode of the Four Beauties of China. 四大美人。So last time I told you the story of Yang Yuhuan, and today I'm going to tell you the second beauty. Her story is actually taken from the most famous Chinese historic novel, 三国演义, Romance of the Three Kingdoms. And her name is Diao Chan. Diao Chan was the most beautiful woman in the 14th century in China. She was also one of the most significant and mysterious female characters during the Three Kingdoms period. And her story is most linked to the famous political strategy, 美人计.美人 means beauty, 计 strategy. So 美人计 the beauty strategy. It's basically a type of strategy where you use a beautiful woman to seduce or to deceive a man for your own benefits or your purpose. Just like Diao Chan, she was used by her master to seduce two most powerful men in those days. And with her smart tricks and her success, she eventually tried to help to get rid of one of the most vicious enemy. So today we're going to uncover the mystery and to find out how she achieved all of this. So Diao Chan is the star of this episode, and I'm going to give you her story in Chinese. 1st let's preview some key vocabulary we're going to encounter in the story. Number 1, a famous Chinese idiom and the strongest phrase to describe a woman's beauty. 国色天香国色天香国 national 色 color 天 heavenly 香 fragrance It means dazzling beauty. 收养收养 show to take, 养 to keep. So 收养 to adopt. 神秘神秘神 means God, 秘 means secret. So 神秘 mysterious. 恶毒恶毒恶 means evil, 毒 means poisonous. So 恶毒 vicious. 引诱引诱引 to lead 诱 to lure So 引诱 seduce And 绝望绝望绝 means to end 望 means hope So 绝望 desperate Now let's enjoy the story in slow speed And please read after me to practice your spoken Chinese貂蝉的故事貂蝉是中国古代四大美女之一她国色天香是三国时期最神秘的女人貂蝉是个歌女，因为从小被大观园王允收养，所以对王允很忠诚。当时王允最大的敌人叫董卓董卓是个恶毒的大官他控制着皇帝和政府 不仅乱杀人，还吃人肉。王允一直很想杀死董卓。可是董卓身边有个武功极高的干儿子，叫吕布。董卓有吕布的保护，大家都杀不了他。直到王允想到了美人计，就派貂蝉去引诱吕布。吕布一见到貂蝉，就疯狂地爱上了她。然后，王允又把貂蝉嫁给董卓。吕布每天看着最爱的女人和别人在一起，非常绝望。貂蝉聪明地玩弄这两个男人，一边讨好董卓，一边悄悄地和吕布约会。还经常向吕布抱怨董卓，说自己只爱吕布一个人。最终，吕布为了得到貂蝉，就和王允结盟，把董卓杀死了。董卓死后，吕布被皇帝封为大将军。也终于和貂蝉在一起了。可是，他们幸福地生活了几年后，吕布就被他的敌人曹操杀了。吕布死后，貂蝉就神秘地失踪了，没有人知道她去了哪里。
To access lesson PDF, please click the link below, and to subscribe to my channel for more Chinese learning videos.
Now, let's practice your Chinese listening skills in normal speed with Ning Ning face to face. 貂蝉是中国古代四大美女之一，她国色天香，是三国时期最神秘的女人。貂蝉是个歌女，因为从小被大观园王允收养，所以对王允非常忠诚。当时 王允最大的敌人叫董卓。董卓是个恶毒的大官，他控制着皇帝和政府，不仅乱杀人，还吃人肉。王允一直很想杀死董卓，可是董卓身边有个武功极高的干儿子叫吕布，董卓有吕布的保护，大家都杀不了他。直到王允想到了美人计，就派貂蝉去引诱吕布。吕布一见到貂蝉就疯狂地爱上了她，然后王允又把貂蝉嫁给董卓。吕布每天看着最心爱的女人和别人在一起，感觉非常绝望。貂蝉聪明地玩弄这两个男人，一边讨好董卓，一边悄悄地和吕布约会，还经常向吕布抱怨董卓，说自己只爱吕布一个人。最终吕布为了得到貂蝉，就和王允结盟，把董卓杀死了。董卓死后，吕布被皇帝封为大将军，也终于和貂蝉在一起了。可是他们幸福地生活了几年后，吕布就被他的敌人曹操杀死了。吕布死后，貂蝉就神秘地失踪了，没有人知道他去了哪里。 So with the death of 吕布，貂蝉's ending remained a mystery. Some people say that the enemy of 吕布 was stunned by her beauty, hence captured her. And others say that 貂蝉 eventually fell in love with 吕布 due to unable to accept his death, 貂蝉 chose to suicide. Another popular saying that 貂蝉 simply just returned to the hometown of 吕布 and chose to live a peaceful and quiet life.So this is the story of 貂蝉, one of the four beauties of China. If you like my story, please hit the like button. And I will also give you the story of the rest of the two beauties who are just as fascinating and played very important roles in Chinese history. So please remember to subscribe my channel and turn on the notification bell so that you don't miss out any of them. And thank you so much for being with me today. I will see you next time.再见。
Thank you for watching. If you enjoy my content and would like to support my creation, please consider to be my patron. Follow the link below. Your support is highly valued because it will help me to create more and better learning videos.